Good afternoon, Sarah. And we are in, well, the middle of a forest, really, aren't we?
kind of, yeah. I'm stood under the shade of a fabulous oak tree and I'm surrounded by many more. And we have a number of terraces here. Basically, the land that's cleared is what's included. It's 4,400 square metres, possibly a bit more, as sometimes the paperwork is. And we have these terraces, and then there's a large flat terrace at the bottom with these beautiful trees, which I'm sure are lima trees. They have them in tomorrow and they smell absolutely gorgeous when in flower.
Yeah, then, it is. It is a stunning area down there with the trees, isn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah, and you can make tea from them. And then it's bordered by a little ribera, which is a stream, which probably will only run in the winter. But your boundaries are reasonably clear. And from here, we can't even see, oh, I can just about see the edge of the house, but only because I know where it is. It's a very peaceful location. But you have got a village just down the road here, which has got a cafe in it and a mini market.
Well, a couple of villages around, isn't there?
Yeah.
I think you're talking about Carregal, yeah?
I am, yeah.
Yeah, really nice little cafe bar there.
Yeah, and honestly, mini market.
Yeah.
Then we're just 10 minutes from Alviadre, literally.
Yeah.
And probably 15 from Anchiel. So location-wise, it's good, peaceful. The only noisy thing, the crickets are very, very noisy today. Even I can hear them, which is something unusual. So I think I'm going to let Paul fall over rather than me and go first.
Yeah. Yes. Right.
I think you're going to have to go up that top terrace because we just tried to find our way down and we couldn't make it.
It is all a little bit windy. And I'm pointing into the sun, which is unhelpful.
You know what we forgot to say, Paul? Where you were stood.
Yeah.
Maybe if you turned right, or maybe you didn't need to, but that's road access in.
Yeah.
From the rear.
It's from the street, yeah.
Right, you might hear me falling over. I'm falling off my shoes.
Sarah's tottering around in very unsuitable shoes. I don't know what she's wearing.
But we were staying on subject.
Apart from looking fabulous.
Oh, this is brilliant. So we've got to jump.
Yeah.
We might have to cut here.
We might not.
How do you think I'm going to get down there? I'm not doing that on camera. That's just ridiculous.
Come on, just do it. Here's my hand.
Right, if I break my ankle.
You won't.
Oh.
Sturdy. Sturdy set of ankles like that.
Yeah.
Right, okay. So.
That'll be fabulous, right?
Here's that fabulous tree-laden grove or whatever you call it.
Oh, look at the trees, they're gorgeous.
I mean, they are absolutely stunning. They just really are. And here, as I pan around, again, the sun is not exactly my friend here, but there's the rear of the house.
Well, you'd face everything out to the rear here, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I think
breeze.
You would.
That's lovely.
Yeah, suddenly the wind's got up, which is not unpleasant.
No, not at all. It's getting warm.
It is about 30 degrees today.
Vocal.
It's quite
anyway.
Common, isn't it, this time of the day?
Yeah. Maybe if you just turn right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, I think that's what I'm going to do.
Yep. The property has a second urban ruin on it.
There's three altogether, I think, isn't there?
Three?
I think so. Yeah, but this ruin here, I mean, obviously, it's just walls now.
You've just got the side
walls left. But it does give you the right to rebuild. So you could build another house here.
Yeah, if you look, I need to clarify because that's clearly an old wall.
Yeah.
So that would have come out. Now, whether the ruin was just this size or whether it was the size of both of those and that was just an exterior wall, I need to clarify.
Well, I mean, this, you'd have a fairly big urban footprint.
Either way, it's a project to rebuild.
So, yeah, of course. Yeah.
Whereas the main house isn't at all.
No, so that could be renovated easily.
Yeah. And as you said, well, from the inside, looking up to the roof, we were saying the roof looks quite new. I'm not entirely sure it does from the out.
No, it doesn't. But actually, maybe it's just the nearest.
Yeah, the nearest part. Yeah. The other one looks like it needs replacing.
We haven't been, isn't it? Certainly in the relatively near future. But it's a smallish roof and not prohibitively expensive.
No, but yeah, looking at it, it looks very different from inside.
Yeah, I'm not quite sure whether we should go down there or...
Well, we need to get down there. I just seem to be able to find a way. Which is a bit odd because I was here just a couple of days ago and I was definitely down there.
Yeah, you had a man to follow.
He can't find his way down.
I know I'm going to be in all sorts of trouble for saying that.
And there's lots of lovely mint here.
Now, I've never been here before. I haven't got a clue.
Find a way down either.
I think we should walk around the house.
Yeah.
Around the house.
Yeah, literally.
Yeah, literally.
And hope that we can.
And I think the third building I was talking about.
We can get in there. Yeah. So this is your only neighbour here.
Which is having work done at the moment.
Yeah, restoring the property. Yes, you need to see the house from the outside, don't you? So they're having.
Yeah. I mean, this is the outside. Of course, it's had all this mortar slapped on it. But you could expose all this.
Yeah, it's a tad untidy, in fairness.
It's scruffy.
It's literally been slapped on, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Now, this property here, there you go. I knew there was an ambulance.
Yeah, it's the third building I was referring to. That's included, yes?
Yes, it is. And the boundary's on the other side.
Yeah.
I want to be able to get in downstairs, but okay, we'll come back. So, yeah, again, a stone building.
Also has vehicular access.
Yeah, so if you want it as a garage, or to extend it as and have a Well, what do we call those things?
No idea, Sarah.
A wooden extension, so you can just park underneath it.
Yeah.
I mean, that's actually
an awning.
No.
You could actually turn that into a little studio.
You could. That could be a very nice workshop.
Yeah.
And so the boundary literally runs, well, it runs along the Ribera, which is just on the other side of where it's, everything's very tall. It's where the land's been cut.
Yeah.
And then if we go, I think we should go into the trees just because they're so nice.
I like it when she leads me into forest.
And there's water on the land. There is a well on the land. Can't quite remember where. I haven't fallen in it yet, so that's good.
No, that's good. That's good.
That's good. So I'm not going to hunt too much.
Yeah.
Oh, I am going to fall over though. Yeah, beautiful shade. Look how tall they are. Go on, do an up. Up, 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 up. Beautiful. That just makes, I mean, the oaks are fabulous, olives are fabulous, but this is nice, nice and different.
Yeah, it is. And
shade all summer.
The smell is gorgeous.
Yeah. And I guess the well is over there by the bamboo.
Yeah, that would make sense.
It would, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
And you can get from here a better view of the property because obviously only one half of it has an underneath. It's on a slope.
The bottom door looks like it's open.
Yeah, I'm going to go and find out in a minute. So we've got a possible stone workshop on the left or a little studio apartment.
Yeah.
You can put a wooden cover-up for car parking.
Carport. Yeah.
House. That's another urban footprint that you can build.
Yeah.
That's 4,500 square metres of land. Yeah. Lots of trees and shade.
Yeah.
And a stream in the winter.
Yeah, I think it's
one neighbour.
It's all very viable, isn't it?
Yeah, it's beautiful. I really like it.
I really like it too.
Let's see if we can get into that underneath.
I wonder what these big churns were for. They look like old-fashioned milk urns.
Urns. I was going to say ferns. It's random weeds, darling. We've seen them everywhere. Well, they're from olive oil. I mean, in England, you say they were milk, wouldn't you?
Yeah. Well, that's what was confusing me. They often say iron ones. Yeah, I'm reasonably sure this is not supposed to be open.
I remember you. Oh, wow, that's cool.
Yeah.
Okay, so this has got good height. I'm not sure about the beams.
No.
in all honesty.
They're not in the best condition at all.
No.
They're not spongy, and you can tell when you're walking above that they're not dangerous.
Yeah, no, it doesn't feel dodgy at all from above.
But they are infected.
But I'd say, yeah, you've definitely got some sort of treatment to do.
Yeah.
But, I mean, and the other obvious thing is, if you want to interconnect this part of the property to the house, you just do through there. You've already got it.
Like, yeah.
The concrete beam put in there. I mean, okay, they're your stairs up to the upstairs, but I'm sure if you got clever, you put stairs up here, put a turning circle and go up, you could do something there, couldn't you? Which interlink three levels of the property.
It's linkable, yeah.
Absolutely. Put those to glass doors, and you had light coming down here.
It was obviously for animals, wasn't it?
Yeah.
But
well, I'd say actually it's probably Nadega, but it would work for both, depending on the time of year. It's a mud floor, so this can get scraped out a bit, levelled off. So you could have a three-storey house on one half at least. Do what I'm told, you know.
Yeah, so I'm just going to cross over the side to get more of a view of
how the
house looks like.
Oh, right, I need to speak to this man. You keep going. Ciao! Okay. Right, okay, I've made my meetings.
The builders and the
builders. I've got two more listings from these guys, but they've just wandered off. But anyway.
Have you got their contacts?
I know where I'm meeting them at 10:30.
Right.
The water counter's in.
Yeah, the water meter.
Right. Means.
Yeah, the gate needs widening.
Awesome steps put in.
Well.
From down there.
Yeah, I mean, there are multiple places where you can actually go.
You just need to link it, don't you? I mean, actually, we haven't. That's a fruit tree there, though.
What
fruit tree? In fact, the fruit tree right in front of us. We've got an orange, two oranges, I think, in front of us.
Oh, yeah.
One apple here on my right.
These are, in fact, orange.
I really wish they were ripe because I'm so thirsty. That's another apple down there, something going red. We've just been focused on the really big tall lemurs.
Yeah.
But there's, I think that's a lemon.
But there are fruit trees.
So we do have citrus. Lots of olives, lots of oak, and I suppose let's go in this way.
Making some light adjustments, there we go.
Nice lintel. Yeah, actually, if you're looking at the wall, I mean, you could see it from outside, but I mean, literally, just...
Yeah. It wouldn't take much cleaning.
Really not. No.
No.
And then it would look nice. This isn't the prettiest.
No, it would look lovely, all exposed up.
Yeah. So, in you come. And, yeah, so this is the part that's got the new ceiling and beams, isn't it?
Yeah.
But you're quite right, that part there hasn't got an enormous footprint of ceiling, so it's not going to cost you a fortune. The ceiling in there would need replacing as well.
Yeah.
Because you've got here
the feature
of the bread oven. But then when you get to the other... Oh no, God, I've got to do it.
Yeah, the bread... Hey, you're going to say hello through the brother.
Oh, yeah. Hello.
Hello. It's moving on. Obviously, this was the kitchen. That's the old original fireplace with the big chimney.
It's good that you've got light coming in through the window above the door, which is unusual.
Yeah.
So again, and you've got light coming in the window on the opposite side. And if you put the door to glass and then through here, I don't see any reason why you'd block that off. We've got you might want to you need a new roof anyway, so you might want to raise the height a little bit on this.
Yeah, there's the remains of the old bread oven.
Yeah,
Sarah just poked her head through.
Yeah, I mean, in one way it's quite good that it's gone because you've still got the feature at the front.
Yeah.
Bathroom here. Bathrooms for quite short people, apparently.
Yeah, the door height needs adjusting, doesn't it?
No, yeah.
The height well, that's actually, it doesn't look difficult.
But anyway.
Bit of a spring.
Functions.
Bit of a spring clean and this bathroom is ready to go.
Spring clean. bottle of bleach, my dear.
The thing is, you could.
Yeah, no, you could come
could
in here.
Yeah.
We could.
Yeah.
Yep. Kids might complain a bit. Right, so up there, we've decided we're not getting the ladder out. Well, Paul has decided he's not getting the ladder out. Do you want to see how much you can see?
Well, you can't really see anything, but I can tell from here that there's reasonable height in the middle.
at least a metre each side. It's not that unlike
our old... You could put a bedroom or two up there. Yeah, I agree, you could.
That unlike our old attic space. And we had...
Quite a lot different.
Four of us living up there. So, we've got one bedroom on the right. Very typical Portuguese layout.
Yeah, I'm going to go in here, Sarah.
Oh, in fact, I've just noticed the tilt on the windows. That's brilliant. That's like our old window frames. And we actually managed to do it ourselves.
Yeah, so I mean, actually slightly larger than typical Portuguese bedroom.
What? Yeah, look at the angles on that one. We managed to achieve that from new. Authentic. Right, so you have, this would be your lounge area, it's one bedroom, just gone past two bedrooms, and then a third one here.
The ceilings are all...
Lovely. Yeah. Just not...
They are...
I've got the same problem on this door. I was trying to shut the door to show that you could use it.
I'm not sure how it was. But it's not a good look.
So go in that one.
Yeah, I mean, the windows are not that old either. Yeah, this is a more typical size for a Portuguese bedroom, isn't it? The other two are larger than normal, but it is all quite doable.
Can you get the view out there?
The view, yeah, there's a little balcony and steps, and I'm going to go and stand on them. Adjust my light before I do that.
I've already stood on that, it's fine.
Because it is lovely. This is a really nice place to sit.
A good height. And of course here...
Like stone steps. Where... And then your real seating area, where I think you'd probably spend a lot of time, is down there near the front door.
Yeah. Well, if your kitchen goes in there, it makes sense, doesn't it?
It does make the most sense.
If you wanted to, that could come further across.
But yeah, it's a decent-sized house, isn't it?
I'm not saying that. Right, so the floors from here, see the floors look fine, but beams underneath were put to you because the ceilings...
If you treat them, you get another 10 years out of it. You know, I've no doubt because there is no sponginess.
So that's where the stairs are coming up from underneath, isn't it?
Yeah.
Here. I think we've done it really. I mean, it's not the hugest of cottages, but it's a good size. You can certainly make either three smaller bedrooms or two larger bedrooms and a nice living area. You can include downstairs as well.
Yeah, but
then of course you've got the build you can do next door and the wooden, the stone building down there. Excuse me.
The unique selling point is the extra urban footprints that the property's got, isn't it?
Yeah.
You know, you've got a decent sized home right here. You can have a really nice two-bedroom property here, no problem, even without utilising the attic. And you can build another house next door, studio apartment or shed. You know, you've got all that forest area to play
with. Loads of potential.
Yeah. I mean, location-wise, it's also really good. I mean, we're close to the town of Pussiflores. As Sarah already said, Carregal, where you've got the cafe. Alvayazara is, 7 minutes?
Something like that.
Yeah, six or seven minutes to Alvayazara. Half an hour to Coimbra. An hour to the seaside. And we can argue about which beach if you want, but, you know, it's an hour to the seaside. And as usual, there are lots and lots of river beaches nearby.
Should we go outside?
If you want to, sweetheart, yeah.
Well, I'll be honest, you're blinding me and I can't see your face. So I can't lip read what you're saying.
Right. Well, that's fine. I'm happy just to talk.
I'll just let you waffle.
I'm not actually blinding Sarah, by the way. It's the light on top of the camera, which I shall now turn off. we don't need it anymore.
You, isn't it, dear? No. Right, there we go. Thank you. Right.
Don't
sing.
Okay, right.
That's what the children say in the supermarket as well.
Yeah.
Right, okay.
It's too dark.
We were meant to be not waffling, and we seem to have done an awful lot of waffling.
We've done more than we should have done.
So, summary. Paul's just done the summary. So, yes, there you go. This
like
is what
and
it
subscribe.
Is. Nice new listing. So, come and have a look. Thank you for watching. See you next time.